Welcome back to Mobile One The Grid. Touring cars now as we speak to the champions of three of the world's best series to find out which comes out top. Now the German Touring Car Series and Australia's V8 Supercars are international events. We thought it's time to pit them against the World Touring Car Championship.
Hi, I'm Rob Huff, World Touring Car Champion. World Touring Cars is by far the best championship in the world.
G'day, Jamie Wincup here. I'm the current V8 Supercar Champion, and my series is by far the best out there.
I'm Bruno Spengler, DTM Champion 2012, and DTM is definitely the best. The top speed can go up to 270, 280 kilometers an hour. You can pull on the brakes and in the corner up to 3 to 3.5 Gs. The engine is a 4-liter V8, 480 horsepower. The car weighs about 1,100 kilo with driver.
The Chevy Cruze is a 1.6 turbo, delivering about 300, 320 horsepower, about 500 newton meters of torque. It's a 6-speed sequential gearbox. It weighs about 1,040 kilos. Slick tires, big brakes. It's just a great touring car.
A V8 supercar is 1,350 kilos. It's got about 650 brake horsepower, big brakes, slippery tyres, and the best thing about our sport is you can pretty much have every panel fallen off the car and still be competitive. Recently, the V8 Supercar Championship has had a big influx of international drivers, and it's dog-eat-dog out here, and generally when they come in as rookies, they find it quite difficult.
The World Touring Cars has got some of the best touring car drivers in the world. It's got a lot of ex-Formula One drivers that have now turned touring car drivers. It's a world championship. You know, you don't get Mickey Mouse races in a world championship. All of these guys, they're the top touring car drivers in the world. It's the place to be.
DTM, for me, I think it's the funnest car to drive because it's just performing so well on the racetrack. And as a racing driver, you're always looking for a lot of adrenaline. That's why you race cars, because you like adrenaline. And these cars gives you a lot of adrenaline because you have so much downforce and it allows you to drive this car as you would drive a single-seater. And that's why I think DTM is the best.
While some of the car is quite simple, a lot of it's really, really advanced. A MoTeC data logging system, in turn with our telemetry that goes back to the pits, is top-notch. So awesome tool to try to improve our driving.
For me, the World Touring Cars is the spectator's favourite. You know, the V8, they're too fast in a straight line. The DTM, they've got too much aerodynamics. Touring cars is where it's about. We're all about bouncing and having fun.
The rules in DTM allow us to do a lot more on the aerodynamic side, and that's why we are also so much quicker. Cars are developed in the wind tunnel with the maximum downforce we can have, and you can see how quick these cars go through the corners.
I love all forms of motorsport. I race current cars, and I race GT cars, and I race historic cars. I'd love to have a go in a V8. I'd love to have a go in a DTM car. As long as I've got four wheels underneath me and an engine, I'm happy.
If I was to change trades, I'd probably go the World Touring Car direction. We've had Andy Prio in our team as a teammate for a couple of years, so he's told us how cool those cars are, and it's somewhat rubbed off on me.
As a racing driver, you're always open to anything. As long as you are behind a steering wheel, you're happy. So if I get the chance once to try one of these cars, of course, I would definitely be open to do it. They are nice cars too, and they are definitely a challenge to drive, but I'm very happy in the DTM series. Well, DTM is the best because I think our cars are the ones that perform the best on the track, the quickest on the track. You can really brake late and accelerate early into the corner, and there's a lot of corner speed. I think this is very impressive for the fans.
Why is the World Touring Cars the best championship in the world? Simple. It's a world championship. The best guys in the world are there. We've got the best cars, short, sharp sprint races. The action's ever so close. It's fast, it's furious. The cars move around a lot. It's what the fans want to see. And not only that, you can see the cars on a Sunday. You can go into a dealership and buy yourself one on a Monday.
I believe our V8 Supercar Championship is better than the other two. I feel we've got a really good balance between high horsepower cars, not too much aero, slippery tyres, big brakes. It's just a really good recipe for good hard racing. In a shootout between me and the other guys, I think it'll depend a lot on whose car we're driving and around what circuit. But if I got beaten around Bathurst in a V8 supercar, I'd be highly embarrassed.
Straight line, probably the V8 supercar would win because they have a lot of horsepower and they don't have a lot of downforce. But on the normal racetrack, I'm pretty sure the DTM would be by quite a bit the quickest because of the downforce, of course.
So if there was a shootout between me, Wincup and Spengler, I think we should stop talking about it. Let's get it done.